Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part 7 of solving an equation containing a radical. And notice in this equation, which we're going to be solving, there are two radicals. So the technique will be to isolate one radical on one side of the equation and square both sides to get started. So here's our problem. And it doesn't matter which one we isolate. We could keep it the way it is, which means the right side is already isolated and begin by squaring both sides. Or you could subtract one from both sides and square both sides. Let's go ahead and just leave it as it is to get started. So how about if I just square the entire left side and I square the entire right side. Now, you have to be careful here. Remember, when I'm squaring the left side, I have a binomial. So I'm going to write out all these steps. It's really the square root of negative 3x plus 16 plus 1 times the square root of negative 3x plus 16 plus 1. And on the right side, when I square a square root, I just get what's underneath the square root sign. So the right side will just end up being the easy side, negative 4x plus 25. That's what I'll get when I square the right side. Okay, but on the left side, if I do the FOIL method, I will get, first of all, I'm squaring the first terms together, which those are the same thing. So I get again what's underneath the square root sign. So I'll simply get this square root. Let me see. When I square the first term in each, I'll get exactly what's underneath the square root, which will be the negative 3x plus 16. Now, the outer term will be a plus square root of negative 3x plus 16, and the inner term will be another square root of negative 3x plus 16, and the last term will be a 1. Now, you could use the formula for squaring a binomial, and you will get exactly the same thing. You would have the negative 3x plus 16, that would be squaring the first term, plus 2 times the first term times the second term, which is 2, square root of negative 3x plus 16, plus 1, which is the same as just adding these two like terms here, this square root of negative 3x plus 16 plus square root of negative 3x plus 16. That's where this 2 square roots of negative 3x plus 16 comes from. Right, so I've squared one side of the equation, and I could simplify this left-hand side a little bit more. That's up to you if you want to do that step by adding the 16 and 17. All right, but the important thing to note is I still have a square root. So now I have to isolate this square root. So I want to add 3x minus 17 to both sides, right? If I add 3x minus 17 to both sides, I will be able to isolate the left-hand side square root, which is the 2 square roots of negative 3x plus 16. And on the right side, that gives me a negative x and a plus 8. And by the way, you could write that as 8 minus x. That's up to you. Now, I haven't completely isolated the left-hand side. I have a 2 in front of it. That's okay. You basically want to isolate the term that has a square root. And then we're going to do the process all over again. We will square both sides. Okay, so on the left-hand side, notice you have to do the 2 squared and the square root of negative 3x plus 16 squared. So I'm going to write out all the steps just so you can see that. I know it takes a little longer. But in other words, I'm going to do the 2 squared and also the negative 3x plus 16 squared. On the right-hand side, I'm going to write that as negative x plus 8 times negative x plus 8. You don't have to write out all these steps, but I'm doing it for those of you who would like to see every single step shown. So this gives 2 squared as 4. When I square this square root, I get what's underneath the square root, which is negative 3x plus 16. And now I'm going to do the FOIL method over here, but of course you can just use the formula for scoring a binomial. So negative x times negative x is x squared. Negative x times 8 is a negative 8x. The inner terms will be a negative 8x, and I have plus 64 for the last terms. And I have to do the distributive property on the left. So I have negative 12x plus 64. And on the right, I'm just going to add the like terms, these two middle terms. Okay, we're getting close. I've gotten rid of the radical signs. I have an x squared term. That means I have a quadratic. And when you have a quadratic, you set the whole equation equal to 0. So since the x squared's on the right, how about we just add a 12x minus 64 to both sides? So I'm going to add, is it 12x? Add a 12x and minus 64 to both sides. Will give me 0 equals x squared minus 4x. All right, because the 64 minus 64 is 0. Whoops, didn't mean to go that far. Okay, here we are. We're almost done. Now we just factor the right-hand side and set each factor equal to 0. So either x equals 0, or I could say 0 equals x, or 0 equals x minus 4. And of course, 0 equals x means x equals 0. And here, if I add 4 to both sides, I get 4 equals x, which of course means x equals 4. So it looks like I have two solutions, 0 and 4. Now the only way to make sure that's correct is by plugging 0 into the original equation and making sure both sides are the same when you simplify, and then plugging in 4. I'm going to go ahead and do this, and then I'm going to make one more video solving the exact same problem, isolating the other square root, because you should still get the same answers. So we'll just go ahead and check now. But if you would like to see this problem solved by isolating the other square root, for instance, going back up here, if I want to subtract 1 from both sides and then square both sides, in a certain way, it's a little bit easier, that problem. I did it that way as well, on my own first. You can see how that works. All right, but for now, let's go ahead and take this original problem. We're going to check the solutions of 0 and 4. All right, so we're going to check x equals 0. So I write the original equation, and I'm going to plug in 0 for x here, which you can see I've put in the 0 in red. And now let's simplify the left-hand side. So underneath the square root, negative 3 times 0 is 0. So I have 0 plus 16 under the square root, plus 1. And that then is, of course, the square root of 16, which is 4. So I get 5 on the left-hand side. And on the right-hand side, negative 4 times 0 is 0. So I have 0 plus 25 underneath the square root. And that's the square root of 25, which is 5. So x equals 0 is a solution. All right, that checks, right? So now let's go ahead and check x equals 4 right here. Again, my first step is to write the equation and plug in 4 in place of the x's. So on the left-hand side, that gives me negative 12 plus 16, which is the square root of 4, plus 1. And the square root of 4 is 2, so that's 2 plus 1. And 2 plus 1 is 3. So left side simplifies to 3. And let's see, right side. Got the square root of negative 16 plus 25, which is the square root of 9. And the square root of 9 is 3. So x equals 4 also checks, right? They both check. So that means, going way back up here, when I solved it, that that is indeed the correct solution. 0 and 4 is the solution. So back up here, original problem, the answer, whoops. Or solution, better way of putting that, is 0 and 4. And if you'd like to see this problem done again, where you subtract 1 from both sides and instead you're isolating this square root of negative 3x plus 16, then look at my video, Solving an Equation Containing a Radical, Part 8. The arithmetic is slightly easier, the algebra is slightly easier when I do happen to isolate that. Not much difference, though. All right, try this again all on your own. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.